Hello everyone, in this video we are going to study about modes of molecular vibrations, that is stretching and bending vibrations of molecules. We know that when we pass infrared radiation to the molecules, then the molecules inside the sample starts to vibrate. That means infrared radiation causes vibrations in the molecules. Now let's read the first point. A single vibrational energy change is accompanied by a large number of rotational energy changes. That means in a single vibrational energy change, there are large number of rotational energy changes. So, this vibrational spectra appears as vibrational rotational bands. That means vibrational energies change from V0 to V1 involves so many large number of rotational energy changes. So, the vibrational spectra appears as vibrational rotational bands. We know that most of the molecules start to vibrate when they absorb the radiations of 2.5 to 1.5 mu m. That is, in infrared spectroscopy, the absorbed energy brings about predominant changes in the vibrational energy which depends upon masses of atoms present in the molecule, strength of the bonds and the arrangement of atoms within the molecule. See here, changes in the vibrational energy depends upon the masses of atoms present in the molecule, strength of the bonds and the arrangement of molecules within the molecule. So, when the infrared light is passed through the sample, the vibrational and rotational energy of the molecule is increased. So, two kinds of fundamental vibrations are stretching vibrations and bending vibrations. These are the fundamental vibrations that these are stretching and bending. See here, here is a sample. When the radiations, infrared radiations are passed through this sample, there is a vibrational and rotational energy of the molecule which increases. Here the vibrational and rotational energy of a molecule is increased. And two kinds of fundamental vibrations which are stretching and bending are produced. So, let's study about the stretching first. You should keep it in mind that the atoms in molecules are not held rigidly. That means the atoms in molecules are considered as balls and the bonds between them is considered as the spring. See here, for example, let's assume this as a molecule which consists of two atoms. Here, this atom and this atom is visualized as a ball and this bond is visualized as a spring. That means it is visualized as a spring. Now, I have said that in fundamental vibrations, there are stretching and bending vibration. What are these fundamental vibration means? These arises from the excitation from the ground state to lowest energy excited state. That means, here, if we consider it as a ground state, that is V0, then the excitation arises from the ground state to the next immediate level, that is V1. So, the transition is +1. These are fundamental vibrations. That means stretching and bending are the fundamental vibrations. Now let's discuss about the stretching vibrations. See here, in this type of vibration, the distance between the two atoms increases or decreases, but the atoms will remain in the same bond axis, that is bond angle does not change. So you have to remember that in stretching vibrations, bond angle does not change, only the bond length will change. That means the distance between the two atoms increases or decreases, but the atoms will remain in the same bond axis. Now let's study the two types of stretching vibrations. That means there are two types of stretching vibrations, that is symmetrical stretching and asymmetrical stretching. That is symmetrical stretching and asymmetrical stretching. Now let's study about the symmetrical stretching. So let's understand it by taking some examples. See here, let's take CH2 group as example. Here methylene group is the best example for this symmetrical stretching. Here what happens means the two atoms move away from the central carbon atom without change in bond angle. I have already said that in stretching bond angle does not change, only the bond length will change. So the two atoms move away from the central carbon atom. See here, consider it as a CH2, that is methylene group. See here, here is a carbon atom and here is the HH are present. You can see here, this bond is stretching like this and this bond is also stretching like this. That means these are moving away from the central carbon atom. So here is a central carbon atom. So this bond is stretching. Let's assume it as a spring. So this bond stretches and goes up, and this bond also stretches and goes up. So what happened here? Bond length increased. So in symmetrical stretching, what happens means the two atoms move away from the central carbon atom. You can observe that here there is no change in the bond angle. This is about the symmetrical stretching. The two atoms move away from the central carbon atom. Now let's study about asymmetrical stretching. Here in the asymmetrical stretching, when one bond is compressing while the other is stretching, this type of stretching is known as asymmetric stretching. See here, consider the example CH2 only. Here the carbon is present and here are the two hydrogens present. Here one hydrogen atom, that is one bond, is stretching. That means it is elongated, whereas one bond is compressing. You can observe here is the asymmetry present. That means one bond is moving up and one bond is moving downside towards the central atom. You can also say that one bond moves away from the central atom while other bond moves towards the central atom. This type of stretching is known as symmetrical stretching. That means here is a carbon atom. This is moving away from the central atom. So this is coming towards the central atom. So this type of stretching is known as asymmetric stretching. Now coming to the bending or deforming vibrations. What are these bending or deforming vibrations? Here up to stretching, that is symmetric and asymmetric stretching, there is no change in the bond angle. Here also in the asymmetric stretching also you can see there is no change in the bond angle. While coming to the bending or deforming vibrations, here the bond angle changes. This is the important point in the bending and deforming vibrations. In the bending vibrations, bond angle changes. So bending vibrations are classified as in plane bending and out of plane bending. So in plane bending or scissoring and rocking, out of plane bending or wagging and twisting. Let's study about the in plane bending. Those are scissoring and rocking. Let's study what are these scissoring and rocking. You can see that these are in plane bending. That means it is a plane. This occurs on the plane only. It does not occur above the plane or below the plane. This occurs on the plane only. So in this type, two atoms approach each other, that is they may move towards each other or move away from each other. So here the deformation of the bond angle takes place. So here you can see two atoms approaches each other, that is they may move towards each other or move away from each other. That means move towards each other. This atom is also moving like this. This atom is also moving like this. That means these two are approaching each other and moving away from each other. Approaching each other and moving away from each other like this. So here the change of bond angle takes place. That means when they approach each other, bond angle change takes place. And when they move from each other, bond angle change takes place. So here the bond angle change takes place. Consider it as atoms. So these two atoms approaches each other and moves away from the each other, approaches each other and move away from the each other like this. So this is about the scissoring. Now coming to the rocking. In this type, the movement of atoms takes place in the same direction in the plane. That means if this atom moves like this, this atom also move like this. If this atom move like this, this atom also moves like this. See here, these scissoring and rocking are in plane vibrations, in plane bending vibration. That means they are not coming up or down the plane, but they are on the plane. Consider these two are two atoms. You can observe that these are on the plane and the movement of this atom takes place in the same direction. See here, if this atom move like this, this also will move like this. If this atom moves like this, this atom also moves like this, like this. This is the rocking vibration, like this. Here the movement of the atom takes place in the same direction, that is in the plane. Now coming to the out of plane vibrations in bending. Those are wagging and twisting. See here, wagging and twisting. Now let's study about wagging first. Here it is the carbon and these are the hydrogen. We are taking methylene group as an example. See here, two atoms moves up and down the plane with respect to central atom. These are out of plane. That means they can occur above the plane or below the plane. Here two atoms move up and down the plane with respect to central atom. See here. Here I have represented plus plus. That means they will move up or move down. If this atom moves up, this atom will also move up. Such type of vibrations are called as wagging, but these are out of plane. That means see here, like this. The vibrations are like this. These two will move up or down the plane. But these are not on the plane. You can observe it is coming up and it is going up. But they are moving same with respect to each other. This atom is moving front and this atom is also moving front. That means up, down like this. This is the example for wagging. Now coming to the twisting. It is also out of plane. Here in this type, one of the atom moves up the plane while the other moves down the plane with respect to central atom. It is exactly opposite to that of the wagging. See here, here one atom moves up while the other atom moves down. See, I have represented plus. That means it is moving up, while minus means it is moving down. That means one atom is moving up and other atom is moving down. If it is coming up, it is moving down like this. This is the twisting. One is moving up, one is moving down like this. This is about the twisting. In this type, one of the atom moves up the plane while the other moves down the plane with respect to central atom. This is about the modes of molecular vibrations in infrared spectroscopy. See here, important point is that in a molecule containing more than two atoms, all the four types of vibrations may be possible. Only those vibrations that result in change in dipole moment of the molecules are observed in the infrared and they will give the infrared graph. These four vibrations are possible in a molecule which consists of more than two atoms. But only those vibrations that result in change in dipole moment of the molecule are observed in the infrared and they will give bands or peak in the infrared spectroscopy. This is about the normal modes of vibrations in infrared spectroscopy. Thank you for watching.